very important part of the CTO office agenda is to see how we can accelerate our efforts towards our Horizon 2 agenda, how we can work with our clients and figure out meaningful ways to transform what they do using technologies like artificial intelligence, using phenomena like augmented reality, virtual reality, and everything that this new wave of computing revolution is offering in front of us. With this idea, we have this very exciting event going on today, the Immersive Experience Day, where we have brought in handpicked 10 startups from across India. Each of them very passionate and focused on this space. They have been building cool solutions from what you can do in healthcare using augmented reality or virtual reality, how you can do trainings and simulations in an industrial context using immersive experiences. There are startups which are talking about how you can take education experience to the next level, leveraging some of these technologies. There are assessment companies which are figuring out gamified mechanism. It's really fun to see the action all around. You have your colleagues from all the offices, from Bangalore, from Nagpur, from Gurgaon, all assimilating at our Noida campus and so immersing themselves in beautiful experiences that a lot of these companies are demonstrating.
VR is something which all of us can look up to and something that we can chase and find really interesting. When I tried taking one of the demos out here, I myself found it like very interesting and very easy to learn. So I feel all in all it's a great thing which has happened here and we all look forward to it.
I must really start by saying what a pleasure it is to host this AR-VR Immersive Experience Day here in Noida. This is one of our largest global centers and the largest center in India, and it truly enthuses me to know that the best of our engineering talent across the country has gathered today to understand what's happening in the startup ecosystem. I think the one thing which really stands out for GlobalLogic has always been its entrepreneurial spirit, right? So while we have become a large organization and a very global organization into many, many different industries, the one thing which we have always been able to maintain has been the true innovation and entrepreneurial culture. And I think we need to have that pulse check every now and then to understand what's happening in the industry. Our employees need to experience what's the cutting edge work which is happening, in real time. And I think AR-VR is definitely at a stage where it's taking off.
And it is a great experience that we had here in terms of VR and how technology is coming up. What was interesting for me to actually find out that there is more analytics to it and then just the virtual reality or the visualization. So different booths that we have attended here and how engaging it can be for a customer experience is what we have learned here today.
What a great day it has been. Puneet, this was genuinely a pleasure hosting this jointly with you. Thank you for flying down here. I can easily see at least 4 to 5 clients who would be very exciting in leveraging, all the action which is happening within the India ecosystem, right? And AR-VR is an area which is really exploding now.
While we are already doing incredible stuff with our clients in these areas, it sometimes makes sense to expose ourselves to the best that is happening around. When you see the state of the art, it sort of ups your ambition, it creates that excitement and lot of energy which these startups exhibit is very infectious. You just sort of start falling in love with what you are doing a lot more. Equally important is the other point that you're trying to say, which is that there are already clear ideas emerging about what we can do with our clients. We are experienced in healthcare, in retail, in manufacturing space, in quality control, in education, in even industries like oil and gas. So we got exposed to a range of industrial application. We were exposed to at least 15 to 16 different case studies. And we already have 4 or 5 industry specific business proposition where the first level of thought has been articulated. I think over the next few weeks, we will detail it down and come back with specific propositions that we can take to the client. So I think it feels very fulfilling that we not only had fun and there was cool stuff, but we have real stuff that we can use to take our client value proposition process forward.
Absolutely, and there is only positives to take back from here, and we should do this much more often. Perfect. Thank you.